forward to this week's video. I'm going to do a DIY project. Yay! I've been seeing these flannels or button-up shirts that have writing on the back, and first time I saw them, I'm like, oh, that's really cool. And then I'm like, I could do something like that. So I finally did it because I have a couple of flannels that I've kind of been wanted to do something new with them, so I did that. And this is going to, and I'm going to show you how I did that in this video. The quote that I used on the back comes from Hamilton, the Hamilton musical. It is from the song, what is the song called? My Shock. It is Young, Scrappy, and Hungry. Thought it was a funny kind of, like a cool kind of quote to put on the back of a t-shirt or flannel or whatever. But yeah, this is how I did it. It was super easy. I think it took probably 30 minutes-ish to do. That included filming. It takes about 24 hours total to complete because of drying time. But yeah, this is what I did, and I hope you enjoyed this video. I can't wait to see your video next week. Bye. The things you'll need are flannel can be used or new. You'll need white acrylic paint and fabric medium, or you can use white fabric paint, freezer paper, cardboard, the words that you want to do so you can trace them out, or you can freehand this all if you want. You'll need a paintbrush, an X-Acto knife, and not shown in the this little bit, you also need a cutting board and a iron. First, you're going to want to take some freezer paper about the size of what you need and tape it down to your cutting board to make sure that it doesn't move while you are tracing your stencil. Next, you're going to want to place down your stencil and also tape that down so it doesn't move during it. And then you're just going to take a pencil and trace your stencil onto the freezer paper. You definitely want to make sure that the shiny side of the freezer paper is down on the table so that you can iron that onto your clothing later. After you finish your first word, you can move on to your next word and line it up. Make sure you tape it back down so they don't move, and then continue tracing until you finish all of the words that you want to put on the back of your shirt. Once you finish chasing out all of the words, you can now start cutting them out with an X-Acto knife. I find that's the easiest. If you want, you can use scissors. And just carefully cut everything out. Make sure that you don't cut yourself in the process of doing this. And just take your time so that you can make sure everything looks perfect and neat. Because what you're cutting out is what's going to show up on your shirt once you start painting. I did while I was cutting, when I got towards the end of cutting the letters out, I plugged in my iron and I turned it on to the dry setting, so like one or two or something like that. Make sure no steam comes out, and you want it to get really hot so that it will adhere the freezer paper to your fabric when you're ready for that. It is now time to iron on your freezer paper to your flannel. What I did is I cut down the sides of the freezer paper just to make it fit a little bit easier so that I can see and get it centered more easily. Then you're going to want to line up your freezer paper onto your shirt, making sure it's as straight as possible and centered as possible. I kind of use the lines of the flannel or the plaid to help center the words to make sure that it's straight. Then once you have it centered and how you want it, just take the iron, your hot iron, start ironing it onto your shirt. If you have any tiny little like flaps from like the small letters that come up, make sure that those are pressed down before you iron them and smooth so that they don't get bumped. have this medium that can turn any acrylic paint into fabric paint. So you just, it's one part medium to two parts of paint. So I just mix that in. If you have regular, just plain old white fabric paint, you don't have to do this step. Put down cardboard so that the ink doesn't bleed through onto your work surface and keeps it all nice and neat. Then you're going to start painting. To paint, you want to do like dabbing motions so that the ink doesn't get underneath the freezer paper and bleed and create weird lines. I did one coat, let it dry for about 20-30 minutes, then I did another coat of the white just to make sure it's opaque and looks good. I let it sit in 20-30 minutes in between each coat, and then after the second coat I let it sit for another 20-30 minutes, and then I peeled off the freezer paper. You can use an X-Acto knife lightly to help pick up the small parts that didn't pick up when you pulled all the way, when you were pulling off the freezer paper. After that, you're going to let the paint dry flat for 24 hours, and then you're going to heat set it. All I do to heat set it is I pop it into the dryer for probably like 30 minutes and let the dryer heat set it, and then you are free to wash it regularly and wear it like normal.
Scrappy and hungry.